night or the continuation of the derivation of the common Laplace transforms. And for the next common Laplace transforms, we have T n u of t is equals to n factorial over s n plus 1. So we have to prove from the time domain to the s domain or the Laplace domain. So to derive that, we have Laplace t raised to n u of t is equals to the integral from 0 to infinity e raised to negative s t, then insert the function e raised to n u of t dt. So we will now apply integration by parts. So u du dt. In this equation, we have u as the variable t raised to n, and the derivation of that is n t raised to n minus 1. Then dv would be e raised to negative xt. We have the integration of that as 1 over s negative e raised to negative xt. So now we will substitute that in the integration by parts formula, uv minus integration of v du. So uv, we have t raised to n, and v as negative 1 over s t raised to negative s t minus the integration of v and du. So now we will limit this part. The limit of this part we have from 0 to infinity. So negative 1 over s is a constant, so we will have that on the other side. Then t raised to, we were supposed to be substituting in 0 infinity to t. So infinity raised to n minus 1 over s e raised to negative s infinity. We don't have the negative s. Minus 0 n e raised to negative s 0. So now we will continue. For now, this will be equivalent to 0, and this one will be approximately 0. So 0 multiplied negative 1 over s will just end up equals to 0. So the limit of this is definitely equals to 0. So we will now continue this part. I'm just going to erase the parts in here so I can continue like this. I'm just going to write that down. Equals to the integral of negative 1 over s e negative s t. And you can actually just put this on the other side though, because this, the negative 1 over s is constant. So integral then t n minus 1 dt. Got it? So now, this is just basically integration by parts. So we will just deal with this side. So apparently n is constant, also negative 1 over s is constant, so we could move them to the other side already, making them as positive n over s. Integration of e negative s t raised to n minus 1 dt. If you could notice, this is just the Laplace of t raised to n minus 1 u of t. Now n over s on the other side. So we could just substitute values for the 10. So we could determine the Laplace transform of the equation. So now we could start from n is equals to 0. So substituting 0 over here, 0 over s, e raised to 0 minus 1 is equal to 0. So we could just actually start from 1. So substituting 1, we have 1 over s plus of t 1 minus 1 u of t. So t raised to 1 minus 1 plus t raised to 0. T raised to 0 plus t is 1. So 1 times 1 over s will be 1 over s. So that will be the Laplace of u of t. As recall, there we go. We have the first one. The plus of u of t is equal to 1 s at n is equal to 1. So we will now have n is equal to 2. So 2 over s the plus of minus 1 u of t. So now we will have t raised to 2 minus 1, we just end up with 2 1 2 over s. So remember we have this one in the previous part, which is equivalent to 1 over s squared. So we can just multiply t over s squared. We will now have that as the Laplace transform t squared u of t. So I'm just going to list that down. We have from the previous part the Laplace of t u of t as 1 over s squared. We have obtained t squared u of t is now 2 over s multiplied 1 over s squared. So now we have n is equals to 3. So 3 over s Laplace of t 3 minus 1 u of t. So now we can recall that as Laplace of t squared u of t, which is actually this part. We multiply that to 3 over s, 2 over s, 1 over s squared. So we could notice some patterns in here, like incrementation of the variables. So we can now just list that down as the plus of t cubed u of t is equal now to 3 over s multiplied by 2 over s, 1 over s squared. So now at n is equals to 4, we have 4 over s Laplace of t 4 minus 1 u of t. So this will be just t cubed u of t. Recalling that part in here, we could just multiply it to 4 over s, 3 over s, 2 over s, 1 over s squared. So we can notice some patterns in here that the more you increase the n value, the part in here will just increase in like incrementation. So we will discuss it through that pattern as n factorial. So this, in this part, we have 4 factorial, and in the denominator, we have s. Also, in the incrementation of every exponent of the variable s, such as in this part, if we will have this last part, it will be 4 over 4 factorial over s raised to 5. So if our n value is 4, and this is 5, plus 1. So this will prove that the robust transform of the function t raised to the degree of t is equivalent to n factorial over s raised to n plus 1.